semifinals of the 110th Mass Amateur at George Wright. Patrick Frody taking on Alex Jamieson in the semis after eliminating defending champ Matt Parziali in the quarters in the morning, 3-2.
That was a lot of fun, very mentally exhausting. I got in and I was very tired into the clubhouse, but it was a lot of fun. We had a great match, and I haven't really played against him one-on-one in a long time, so it was good to be back at it with him.
A quick start for Frody in the semis.
You got off to a nice start, got up by a couple holes.
Yeah, I had a good start. Made a solid par on one and a good birdie on two. Then Alex quickly came back and won two holes on me, and it was a great match all day. We were pretty much back and forth the whole day.
Turning point, maybe 15th, going up by a shot there.
So. Yeah, 15. That was a great, that was a big putt I made. I think that was the turning point in my head. I felt like going two up there with three to play. I kind of had control at that point, and I just had to hit shots in the right positions.
Frody lost 16, but bounced back to close it out on 17.
Parziali and the medalist, and on your way to the final, that's not a bad trip.
Yeah, it's been an exciting last couple days.
In the other semi, veteran Herbie Akins fell behind one of the young guns, Andrew O'Leary.
He's a great player, man. He hit his driver straighter than almost anybody I've ever seen outside of maybe Matt, but he just striped it all day. So he was tough. I just tried to hang in there and see what I could do, and I tried not to get too down. I'm not going to lie, turning, to the back nine down three was a little discouraging. But
after getting one back, Akins avoiding disaster on 11.
Well, that was not where I wanted to be. I hit what I thought was a pretty good shot, spun it right off, and I just committed to the chip shot, and fortunately it landed, spun, and stopped, and I said, oh, all right, that was pretty good. Started to chip away and got a little momentum and made a big birdie on 12, which kind of got me going. I said, all right, we still got a chance at this. So it was fun. 12 was huge. I had a downhill lie. It was pretty tough, and I just really committed to the swing and hit an 8-iron about 5-6 feet and made a good putt to make it, and that kind of got things going a little bit. So
after winning 15 and 16, he was two up on 17 when he let a chance to close out O'Leary slide by.
I was a little nervous on that little putt. I'm not going to lie. I hit on 17. It was a little slower than I thought. I left it, that 4-foot range, and I just came out of it a little bit. And this one, I just said, just stay down. If you miss it, just stay down. So that's what I did. And I heard the noise, and I said, all right, that's good.
It ends on 18. Akins, who survived the quarterfinals in 22 holes, certainly had a long but successful day of golf.
Feel good. A little tired, but great. I'm looking forward to resting up and getting ready for tomorrow. It's going to be exciting.
Feels great. I was in this position a few years ago, so it feels great to be back. It's been a while, and I'm just excited for the opportunity in the morning.
He's a great player. So I think we'll be the tallest finals maybe in history, but yeah, it's going to be a lot of fun.
For a complete look at all your scores, brackets, and results, make sure you visit massgolf.org.